Hello students, how are you all? Welcome to Tungal online classes. So in our last video we have started assignment number 2. It consists of 5 chapters: basic concepts in organic chemistry, next hydrocarbons, environmental chemistry, p block elements and redox reactions. So last class we already started nomenclature, isomerism completed. And in this session, I'm going to discuss the next part in the basic concepts of chemistry, that is purification techniques. There are many purification techniques. First one is, there are many purification techniques. Purification techniques. So sublimation, crystallization, distillation, chromatography, solvent extraction. There are 5. So first one is a sublimation. Sublimation means solid is directly converted into gas. Students, it's very difficult to give you the whole information. That's why I am giving brief and simple. I'm giving only important information briefly. Right now. Sublimation means solid is directly converted into gas. Iodine, camphor, such compounds are best examples. And next one, crystallization. Crystallization meaning is, once you take a solid, to this add a solvent, suitable solvent. Thus, our organic compound is soluble in suitable solvent. Then heat it, after that cool it, then we will get a needle like structure, nothing but the crystals. So those crystals are very pure crystals. Examples are KCl and KClO3 separated by crystallization process. Next one is distillation. Very important, students. Distillation process. Distillation is nothing but purification of liquid impurities from liquid organic compounds. Very important. Liquid impurity from liquid organic compound. Impurity liquid and another one, pure organic compound also liquid. Both are liquids. In such cases, you need to heat it. Right, students? Heat it. Whenever you heat, then one will be vaporized, another one will be left. For this 100 degrees Celsius, for this 200 degrees Celsius, boiling point I am writing. So now, at 100 degrees Celsius, impurity will be vaporized out and the pure will be left in our compound, that is called pure organic compound, right? So if these two difference, the boiling point between the impurity and pure compound difference will be greater than 40 degrees Celsius, that is called simple distillation. And next, if it is less than 40 degrees Celsius, that is called fractional distillation. Examples are very important, need to remember, students. If the boiling point difference between the impurity and pure compound will be greater than 40 degrees Celsius, then that distillation is called simple. If less than 40 degrees Celsius, such distillation is called fractional distillation. Next, after this, fractional distillation example is very important, students. Benzene and toluene. Benzene, C6H6 plus C6H5CH3. Benzene and toluene are best example. It's a mixture which will be separated by fractional distillation, right? So after this distillation, next one is simple distillation, fractional distillation. Next one, steam distillation. It means by passing steam, the liquid impurity will be separated from the liquid pure organic compound. So such a distillation called pure steam distillation. Paranitrophenol and ऑर्थोनाइट्रोफिनोल सेपरेटेड बाय स्टीम डिस्टिलेशन वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. आफ्टर दैट डिस्टिलेशन अंडर रिड्यूस्ड प्रेशर वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. Distillation under reduced pressure. Distillation under reduced pressure. It is also called vacuum distillation. Also called vacuum distillation. Sometimes to purify the liquid impurity from liquid organic compound, we are applying the heat. When you heat it at that boiling point, the compound, organic compound, will be broken. So it lost its composition. So to retain their composition, organic compounds, it should be separated as it is without change in its composition. So in such cases, it means heat sensitive organic compounds are there. They will be broken into pieces when you heating during the which one that is a suppression. So in such cases, the used distillation called distillation under reduced pressure. It means the boiling point of the organic compound should be reduced by reducing the outside atmospheric pressure. Hence, it is called distillation under reduced pressure, also called vacuum distillation. Best example is H2O2. Separated from impurities by vacuum distillation, otherwise glycerol, glycerine, nothing much, separated by vacuum distillation from its impurities, right? This is about third method. First one is sublimation, crystallization. Next one is distillation. After this, next method is solvent extraction. Fourth method is solvent extraction. Solvent extraction means by using a suitable solvent, liquid impurities from liquid mixture will be separated. For example, a test tube, it contains liquid impurity and liquid pure compound. Both are there. To this, I am adding a solvent. So close this vessel completely and reverse it, shake it. Then oil layer and liquid layer both will be formed. Based on their density, the impurities will come into oil layer. Oil layer is separated and pure organic compound is separated, right? This kind of extraction is called solvent extraction. So this is solvent extraction. Next, after that, chromatography. Chromo means color, graphy means to write. The principle involved in chromatography is, that's the question they are expecting, students. Chromatography. Principle involved in chromatography is adsorption. Very very important. Previous CET question. Adsorption. Adsorption means it's a surface phenomenon. We know already. 2-3 types are there. We well known, and you just read the theoretical information, right, students? After this, next one is qualitative analysis and quantitative analysis. Now, first one is qualitative analysis. Qualitative analysis. First one. Qualitative means, so we need to find the quality of a given organic compound. Like in your laboratory, you have done salt analysis. No? Similarly, organic compound analysis also we need to do. So they will provide you organic compound. You need to find which element is there, whether carbon, oxygen, nitrogen, sulfur, halogen, phosphorus. So which is available in your compound? For example, first one is carbon and hydrogen. How to identify carbon and hydrogen? So it is our organic compound which contains carbon and hydrogen, students. Okay. So when I added copper
oxide CuO. Then carbon in this organic compound converted into CO2. Hydrogen in this organic compound converted into H2O. And here byproduct copper will be removed. This CO2, when I passed through CaOH twice, then give rise to CaCO3. It's a white color PPT. White color formation indicates the presence of carbon. Next, H2O passed through copper sulfate, then give rise to CuSO4 5H2O. Blue color will be formed. Blue color formation indicates the presence of hydrogen. Colors are important, those only you need to remember, very very important. Next, after this, detection for nitrogen, detection for another elements, detection of nitrogen, halogens, next sulfur, phosphorus, right? These elements. For these elements, the test used is Lesine's test. Very, very important. The test used is Lesine's test. CET questions. Lesine's test, how will you take? You know already capillary tubes. So both sides closed. When you heated one end, it will be closed. So in a capillary tube, take down, it is a capillary tube. To this, add a sodium metal and organic compound and heat it. It should be taken in a mortar. After heating, taken in a mortar it is. It contains sodium metal and organic compound. Right, students? There is a pestle. Here is a pestle. With this, you have to crush it and powder it. Add some water. After that, filter it. The filtrate obtained called, it is filtrate obtained called sodium fusion extract. Sodium fusion extract, very very important students. Sodium fusion extract. Sodium fusion extract is basic in nature, remember, because of strong metal, nothing but sodium is there. Sodium oxides are basic. Now, to do nitrogen test, halogen test, sulfur test, phosphorus, we need to prepare the sodium fusion extract first. And in sodium fusion extract, already I took organic compound, it is available. So by this organic compound in sodium fusion extract, we can confirm whether nitrogen, sulfur or phosphorus or halogen which is present. Now, it will come to know. So, after preparation of sodium fusion extract, what to do? If nitrogen is there, for example, in our compound, nitrogen is there. Yes, nitrogen is there. Then, sodium, already organic compound contains carbon. If nitrogen is there in carbon, then it becomes sodium cyanide. Right, students? To this sodium cyanide, I am adding freshly prepared FeSO4. Freshly prepared FeSO4. Then forms ferric ferrocyanide, that is Fe4, FeCN6. FeCN6. Ferric ferrocyanide, very very important. Outside iron atom is +3 oxidation, it is +2 oxidation. Right? This color is Prussian blue color. Prussian blue color. The Prussian blue color formation indicates the presence of which element, students? Nitrogen. I am not writing the balanced chemical equations. Simply, I have taken the element formed and also the color formed and the color chemical and detection, right? Equations and balancing, no need for us. Only color and this formula. This is for nitrogen. Next element is, after this, sulfur. How do test for sulfur. If sulfur is there, it is sodium fusion extract. It is also sodium fusion extract we have prepared just now. Sulfur is available. It is converted into Na2S sulfur. Right? Sulfur is there, it becomes Na2S. To this Na2S, when I added lead acetate, CH3COO twice, lead acetate, then we will get sodium sulfide lead acetate, then PBS, lead sulfide, lead and sulfide, sodium, and this will be removed as a sodium acetate. Lead sulfide is a black color. Black color formation indicates the presence of sulfur, which is from sodium fusion extract. After this, if sulfur and nitrogen present in our organic compound, if both sulfur and nitrogen present in organic compound, so both sulfur and nitrogen present in organic compound, take the sodium fusion extract, Na from sodium fusion extract, carbon, nitrogen, sulfur. Carbon is organic compound, hence it's common, and nitrogen and sulfur is present, then we will get Na SCN, sodium thiocyanide will be formed, right? Then it will be treated with FeCl3. This will be treated with FeCl3. Then the formed compound is FeCn 6 times minus 2. FeSCn 6 times minus 3 it is. FeSCn minus 2 it is. SCN minus 2. 6 times minus 2. FeCn 6, SCN 6 minus 4 will be formed. It is blood red color. Formation of blood red color indicates the presence of which one, students? Sulfur and nitrogen in our organic compound. So these are the detections of these elements. For example, halogen is there in our compound. So halogens, how do you detect the halogens? Yeah, halogen is there. Then sodium fusion extract, which contains an organic compound also. Halogen is X2, then 2 moles it is, 2 moles of NaX, it means 2 moles of sodium halide will be formed. If it is chlorine, white PPT. If it is bromine, yellow PPT. If it is bromine, yellow PPT. And if it is iodine also, yellow PPT. Yellow PPT for iodine, yellow PPT for bromine, yellow PPT for chlorine also. Chlorine is there, white PPT will be formed, and yellow PPT will be formed, otherwise yellow PPT will be formed by adding AgNO3. Whenever you added AgNO3 to the sodium halide, which is obtained from halogen, that gives different colors. Based on that, we can confirm which color belongs to which. This indicates a halogen, right? And phosphorus also easy, students, you verify once. This is all about the qualitative analysis. It means whether which element is present in our given organic compound. Now, the next one is after this. Quantitative analysis. It means how much percentage of carbon, how much percentage of halogen, how much percentage of hydrogen is present. So quantitative analysis. It means quantitative analysis. So first one is percentage of carbon, how to detect. Usually percentage of carbon is detected from carbon dioxide. So percentage of carbon detected from carbon dioxide, that's why 12 by 44 into weight of carbon dioxide by weight of organic compound into 100. Formula students, it is from carbon dioxide, hence we can easily find. Formula also easy to remember. Percentage of hydrogen is equal to, usually hydrogen is estimated from water which is present in organic compound. Then water contains 2 grams of hydrogen, 18 grams of water into weight of water present in a compound and weight of given organic compound into 100. Right students? This is percentage of carbon and which one, that is hydrogen. Similarly, percentage of nitrogen is very very important. By Dumas method, here nitrogen converted into N2 by Dumas method, previous CET question, that is equal to, so the formula is 28 by 2 to 400 milliliters into, so volume of N2H STP by weight of organic compound into 100. Right? It is by Dumas method important. In Dumas method, nitrogen in organic compound converted into N2 gas. Next one, percentage of nitrogen in Jeldahl's method. Very very important. Here in this method, nitrogen in organic compound converted into NH3. That is equal to, simplified formula will be, so 1.4 into, so volume into normality of a solution by weight of organic compound. These are the simplified formulas, students. They will provide you this weight and this weight. Easy to find percentage of carbon. This one and this one. So easy to find the percentages. Even easy to find the percentages of phosphorus, halogen, chlorine, bromine, iodine also. You just follow the formulas, students. I'm not writing all those formulas. So important one, these four. Nitrogen by Dumas method converted into N2 gas, and nitrogen in organic compound converted into ammonia by Jeldahl's method. Okay, next. After this, this is under a qualitative analysis. Next one is reaction mechanism. Next topic is reaction mechanism. It's a big chapter. I'm giving you only important points, students. Reaction mechanism, which contains reactants, nothing but substrate plus reagent converted into product plus byproduct. It is called reaction. We know already. Now, homolytic cleavage, heterolytic cleavage. Homolysis. Homolytic cleavage is also called homolysis. Then for example, CC, this bond is equally cleaved, then forms C single electron, another C also single electron. These are called free radicals. Homolysis forms free radical. Next, heterolysis, also called heterolytic cleavage. Heterolysis, CH3Cl, I am taking. These two electrons are transferred to one chlorine atom, then becomes CH3 losing electrons, hence positive sign, Cl gaining electron, hence negative sign. It is cation, this is anion. It means it is called carbocation. If it is a carbon, then it is also called carbanion, right?
So now we'll discuss these three.
Before going to these three, we should know about types of reactions.
One is addition reaction, substitution reaction, elimination reactions. These three are very, very important. Addition means reagent and reagent will be added, reagent and reactant. So, substitution means one of the atom will be replaced by another atom. And elimination means one of the atom will be removed from our reactant. So we know already we read electrophilic substitution reactions, nucleophilic substitution reactions, free radical substitution reactions, nucleophilic addition reactions. We read in our second year course, even in the first year course also.
Now, after this, first one is electrophile. Very, very important. Electrophile, carbocation, nothing but positive charged species. So like this C, H, H, plus it is. Methyl carbocation, right? Undergoes sp2 hybridization, planar shape it is. Planar shape. Right, students?
So, electron deficient, positive charged organic compounds these are.
Stability of carbocations is benzyl. Benzyl means first one is tertiary benzyl greater than, it is benzyl students, 3 benzene rings plus tertiary benzyl, next secondary benzyl, okay, only 2 benzene rings, next after that tertiary alkyl it is, next after that benzyl means benzene plus CH2 group, next after this secondary greater than CH3, only 2 carbons connected to the carbocation, secondary greater than, after this allyl also here, actually allyl also should be here, it should be taken. Now order will be greater than order, right students? Reason is resonating structures, there are 15 resonating structures more stable, and here when moved left to right, resonating structures will be decreases, stability also decreases. It means stability of carbocations will be, so tertiary carbocation, secondary carbocation, primary carbocation. It's simple stability order whenever you want. Next, after this, carbanions nothing but negative charged species, negative charge in the sense electron excess species, negative charged will be order primary greater than, secondary greater than, tertiary, reverse order students, primary carbanion greater than, secondary carbanion greater than, tertiary carbanion. But before this, tertiary benzyl carbanion, secondary benzyl carbanion and primary benzyl carbanion. Benzyl carbanions will be same, but carbanions, only alkyl is an alkyl. Alkyl means only chain, and these three will be benzenoid compounds, nothing but benzyl compounds, right? After this, free radical students. Free radical meaning is odd electron species or single electron is available on this. For example, this is carbon, hydrogen. There is a single electron on this. Free radicals undergoes sp2 hybridization, planar. Carbanions undergoes sp3 hybridization, and carbocations undergoes sp2. Free radical stability also almost same to that of carbocation stability. Free radical stability also tertiary greater than, secondary greater than, primary. Only the reverse order for carbanions and carbocations will be prime, tertiary greater than, secondary greater than, primary. Right students, these are free radicals, carbocations, nothing but reaction intermediates. Simple idea I gave, not the full information.
So after this, the next topic is electron displacements.
Electron displacement. Electron displacement. It means electrons are moving from
adjacent bond to atom, atom to adjacent bond, bond to bond. Many kinds of displacements are there. These are four types.
First one is inductive effect. Inductive effect simply indicated as IE. It means here sigma electrons are attracting towards electron withdrawing group or electron donating group. For example, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Here there is a Cl. Cl is more electronegative group. Negative means all the electrons are attracted towards chlorine. It means these sigma bonded electrons are attracted towards to the chlorine side. Then chlorine shows partial negative sign and carbon shows partial positive charge. It means polarization takes place by the adjacent polarization of bond. Hence it is called inductive effect. Inductive effect involves only sigma electrons. It is a permanent effect, very very important. Sigma electrons will be displaced, permanent effect, and partial polarization will be happens. Then inductive effect classified into two types: positive inductive effect and negative inductive effect. Positive inductive effect, negative. Positive means electron donating groups required. Electron donate, here I took a group now. This group is electron withdrawing group, all the electrons from the chain taken. If negative inductive effect is there, electron withdrawing group should be present on a chain. Withdrawing group is there, minus IE. Donating group is there, plus IE. Right, students? Electron donating group examples: methyl, ethyl, nothing but alkyl groups, all alkyl groups. Or amine, NH2 group, etc. Next, withdrawing groups are, it means they will take electrons from the others. So those are NO2, COOH, SO3H, COCH3, OCH3, etc. These all groups are electron halogens, halogens. These all under which category, students? Minus IE effect. After this, the second effect is electromeric effect. Electromeric effect. Electromeric means it is temporary effect. First of all, only pi electrons will be displaced, not sigma electrons. It is a temporary effect. Temporary effect. Pi electrons only shifted. On the demand of attacking reagent. On the demand of attacking reagent. AR in the sense attacking reagent. For example, C double bond C. A positive reagent attacking. It is a reagent, students. Reagent is attacking to reactant. And these two will be shifted here, here minus, here plus. This positive charge reagent gets attacked to reactant. Getting, students? Then gives rise to the formed one is, this becomes positive because losing electrons. Double bond becomes single bond, and there are already two bonds with hydrogen. Right, students? When positive reagent attacked, obviously positive sign left on the reactant. This kind of effect is called positive electromeric effect. Positive attacking reagent, positive charge left. Examples you need to remember: electron withdrawing groups. Otherwise, it is electron withdrawing is there in that case. Positive groups, nothing but. Next, C double bond C. After this, negative reagent Cn minus ending, students. Then these two will be shifted here. It is minus, it is a plus. This minus and plus will be attracted. Then becomes, so minus. So here Cn will be attacked, already two bonds. It is which one? Negative charged ion attacked, negative charge on reactant left, negative electromeric effect. Negative electromeric effect. Getting, students? And this is about electromeric effect. The next effect is after this. Mesomeric effect, also called a resonance effect. Mesomeric effect. Mesomeric effect. So it is indicated by MB, ME, students. Pi electrons and lone pairs will be displaced through the conjugated system. Conjugated system meaning is alternate double bonds and single bonds, called conjugated system, right? So plus ME effect, it is classified into two types: plus ME effect and minus ME effect. Positive mesomeric effect indicates electron donating groups required for us, like alkyl groups, ammonia, etc. Minus ME means electron withdrawing groups are required for us. Electron withdrawing groups, nothing but COOH, NO2, CN, SO3H, already written, students. Right? Next. After this, simply one example, students. And here I am taking, this will be benzene ring, here NH2 group. It will donate electron and this will be donated electron. Donating group, plus ME effect. If it is withdrawing group is there, for example, NO. NO2 is a withdrawing, then what will be happened? These electrons from the ring taken by N, and this will be shifted here. Withdrawing groups and donating groups, right, students? Next, last concept is hyperconjugation. Hyperconjugation is also, students, mesomeric effect is almost equal to resonance effect, remember. Hyperconjugation. Hyperconjugation, also called no bond resonance. It is also called no bond resonance. Hyperconjugation. Here also sigma electrons will be delocalized, and condition one, sp2 carbon atom must sp2 carbon atom. Another condition, one alpha hydrogen must. Alpha hydrogen. In such cases, the sigma electron displacement simply called hyperconjugation. So, example, students. For example, C. So, here H. There is a plus. It undergoes sp2. sp2 next carbon atom is alpha, and these hydrogens are alpha hydrogens. Simply this bond will be shifted here, right, students? Then becomes HCH, single bond becomes double CHH. Here this bond shifted, hence no bond here. This kind of resonance called no bond resonance. So one alpha hydrogen, one more, one more. If three alpha hydrogens are there, three hyperconjugative structure. Four are there, four hyperconjugate. Number of hyperconjugative structures increases, stability also increases. Stability is directly proportional to hyperconjugative structures, that to number of hyperconjugative structures. Right, students, with this the simplified information from the first chapter completed, let us discuss bits from basic concepts of organic chemistry. Okay, students, let us discuss bits from organic chemistry, first chapter, from first year. So now, the hybridization of central atom in this compound is, so if this kind of compound available, that always undergoes sp. Only single bonds are there, sp3. Only one double bond is there, sp2. One triple bond is there, sp. But carbon surrounded by two double bonds, then that also undergoes sp hybridization. Answer A, correct, students. Right? So hybridization of central atom, it is central atom, this is central atom. Right? Next, number of pi bonds in anthracene. Anthracene formula is three benzene rings fused together, then forms a compound called anthracene. Three benzene rings. So there, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Each bond contains 2 electrons, 7 to 14 electrons. Option D, correct for this question. Right, students? Next. After this, 3-methyl-pent-1,3-dienes. 3-methyl-pent-1,3-dienes. So need to find, students. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Yes, I think option C, correct, right answer. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. This is the right number. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So numbering giving clearly here also. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Right, students? Then this is acting as a substituent actually. So 1, 2, 3, 3 methyl, pent 5 carbons, 1, 3 diene. First position, I think it is first position, it is third position. Give numbering 1 and it is 2. This is 3, this is 4 and this is 5. Numbering from right to left. Okay. Next. IUPAC name of this compound is. So this one, we should give first number to the carboxylic acid carbon atom, then 2, then 3, then 4. Right? This is the numbering, students. 1, 2, 3, 4. 3 methyl. 4 means butane oic acid. 3 methyl, 2 or 1 butanoic acid, it is 1 butanoic acid actually. 3 methyl. So here 2 butanoic acid. So 3 methyl. Butanoic acid, it is 1 butanoic acid, students. Right? Option C, correct to this. Okay, students, next bit we'll see now. Which of the following is show metamerism? Metamerism means compounds having same molecular formula but different in the size of alkyl groups, called metamerism. So right option is B, ethyl group, ethyl group. Then next one is methyl propyl. It means two carbons, two carbons. One carbon, three carbons, and one carbon and isopropyl, but not possible in other options. Verify. 14th question. This compound is, these two are identical groups on same side, hence it is a cis isomer. Right, students? Next, racemic mixture is optically inactive due to racemic mixture optically inactive because one compound is cancelled by another one and second cancelled by first. Between two compounds there is a compensation, hence it is called between two compounds, hence it is called external compensation. Where is that external compensation? Option B correct, external compensation. Next, which of the following is optically active? Optically active means we want which one students? Chiral center, SM metric center. Option C correct. How option C correct? We'll see now. CH3, and this carbon I am writing as center, and on this one OH is there. OH I am writing upside, and this hydrogen downside, and left side COOH. This one, all are different groups, chiral optically active, right? Option C correct, students. Next. Okay students, next bit, the configuration of ABC compounds are a little important. RS nomenclature, observe carefully. It is a center one, students. Give numbering as per their atomic number. First of all, carbon, oxygen, hydrogen, carbon. Oxygen atomic number 8, carbon only 6. That's why it is first priority. Okay students, it is first numbering, first one for OH. CO is there, CH is there, H is there. C first, CO, CH, CO first. Right students, CO, CH, H one only. Right, CC same, move to the next atom. Next atom oxygen 8, next atom hydrogen 1. That's why higher priority second. And this is third priority, hydrogen is least priority students, 4 that is. So now 1, 2, 3, 4, it is, the order is like this, 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4 is nothing but it is anti-clockwise, right? So anti-clockwise is there, obviously it will be S configuration. S means sinister, R means rectus. Okay students, first one yes, second one next. Right, now second one is here, the lowest priority group on horizontal line, yes, will be taken as R. Right students, and answer for the first one is R. Next, COOH, OH, C, then oxygen shows first priority, CO, CH, C, CO second priority, and CH, C, it is third priority, it is fourth priority. Carbon, carbon is there, carbon, hydrogen is there. Then 1, 2, 3, 4 again students, anti-clockwise, but lowest priority group on horizontal line, hence S becomes which one? R. It means R, second one also R, first one also R. Next, CN, C2H5, C111, CN, nitrogen, 7 it is, CC, CC, it is first priority, C triple bond C, it means triple bond 3 times, it means carbon 3 times indication, but here carbon only 2 times, that's why second priority, it is third priority, it is fourth priority. So 1, 2, 3, 4, it is clockwise direction, clockwise means usually R, but lowest priority group on horizontal line, R considered as S, R, R, S, first option correct answer, right students. Next, Lezenz test is used for detection of nitrogen, halogens, next one sulfur also, all this, all of this. Right students, next, in Dumas method, nitrogen in organic compound estimated as N2 gas. In Jaldal method, NH3, just now discussed. 0.73 grams of organic compound gave 1.32 grams of carbon dioxide. What is the percentage of carbon? Percentage of carbon formula is 12/44 into weight of carbon dioxide by weight of organic compound into 100. Then finally the substitution will be percentage of carbon is equal to, so that is 12/44 into weight of carbon dioxide 1.32 by weight of organic compound 0.73 into 100. Once you solve it, you'll come to know answer. The answer is A, option A, 49.3. Right? By formula directly we can find. Students, you remember in material they gave around first 40 bits belongs to first chapter of organic chemistry. So among these 40, I'll discuss few bits. Okay, students, I'll move to the next bit. So this will be broken, forms cation and anion. Cation and anion formed by shifting these two electrons to the bromine side. This is called heterolysis, not homolysis. So answer will be option B correct. Okay, next. Methyl carbonium is, carbonium means CH3, onium means carbanion, I think it is. Methyl carbanion, it is carbanion, methyl carbanion, carbanion it is. Methyl carbanion is negative charge, nothing but nucleophile. All nucleophiles are Lewis bases, nothing but electron donors due to excess of electrons. Hence, nucleophile as well as Lewis base. Hyperconjugation is possible in. Hyperconjugation is possible in. Hyperconjugation conditions, alpha hydrogen must, sp2 carbon atom must. Doubly bonded carbon atom is alpha. Next must be sp3 carbon atom. No sp3, doubly bonded, next must be sp3, no sp3, hence it will not. Next, doubly bonded carbon atom, the next is alpha and also sp3 carbon, yes it is possible. Next, doubly bonded carbon atoms, next benzene ring, there is no alpha hydrogen on the ring, hence it will not show. Next, so this is alpha carbon, so but on this carbon there is no hydrogen, methyl groups are there. Instead of CH3 are there, it means it is methyl group but not hydrogen. We want hydrogen, hence it will not also show hyperconjugation. Right option is option B. Doubly bonded carbon atom, nothing but sp2 carbon atom must. The next carbon atom should be there and it should be sp2 and it should have one hydrogen, that is called alpha hydrogen. Inductive effect involves, inductive effect is a permanent effect, it involves the displacement of sigma electrons, displacement of sigma electrons. Students, up to 40, 1 to 40 bits belong to basic concepts of organic chemistry. I have discussed a few bits and remaining few left. So you have to solve these bits at home, and have any doubts post in our group. We'll continue in the next session.